Boys, you ready? Crowd fired up, looking forward to this. In the commentary box for this first quarter final, the rumbling tones of Chris Mason and John Rawling.
I shall attempt not to rumble. Baxter against Thornton. And this is going to be a good match, I think. Two well-matched players. You've heard already that it's 2-1 in previous meetings in Baxter's favour. But Thornton, a man coming into form. Ronnie Baxter, the Rocket, 47 years old from Blackpool, in his first televised quarter-final of the year, as indeed is Robert Thornton. Thornton, 41, from Stevenston in Scotland. And he's 12 months ago, he was still making Venetian blinds for a living, and he's come through, turned pro with the PDC in May, and he is rocketing up the rankings. If he gets to the final here, it'd have moved up to 36 in the world. Robert Thornton there, and he beat the slightly idiosyncratic style of Suljovic, Mensur Suljovic, in the previous round, 9-7. And he will certainly fancy his chances. Robert, whose nickname is the Thorn, Chris, but known slightly differently to the players.
Yeah, we call him Chocolate.
Ronnie, and I'm glad you pronounced the Austrian's name for me.
Ronnie Baxter once came a cropper kissing the camera, didn't he?
Yes, he had a little accident and slipped and nearly knocked himself out, I do believe.
41. Who's going to be the quicker to settle into this match? Ronnie Baxter, by his own admission, against Carlos Rodriguez, didn't really hit top form. And at his best, he can be pretty spectacular.
Yeah, I think we've seen that against Vincent van der Voort from 4-2 down, when Vincent had 68, hit the treble 20 and left put two darts on the wire double four. 96. And Ronnie really didn't look back from that point and showed his experience against Carlos, and Carlos suffered from the lack of experience, I think.
And didn't he get a nine darter in a non-ranking event in Australia?
Yep, the new PDC event in Australia, the warm-up event. Ronnie actually hit a nine-darter to win the match.
Against Robert. Against Robert. Well, he'll know, Robert, all about the capabilities of the man who's against him then.
Yes.
Wife Christine and daughter and grandkid. I wouldn't mind betting they're at home somewhere watching right now.
Yep, nice cup of tea. And we'll see the first 180 of the match from Baxter. Good sign.
That's more like it. Good response.
I had an hour and a half practice this morning with Robert Thornton, and he looked very relaxed and was throwing some super darts, just like those from Baxter, to lead 56 to two dart finish. Robert way back on 183.
His performance in the last round had to come from behind and showed some guts in doing so, I thought. And Ronnie Baxter, an unflappable sort of character now, with 56 to take the first leg. Needs double 10 now. Oh, that's an opportunity missed.
Yep, it's a big shot for Robbie. He'll go treble 20 first start. Yeah, I thought his match, his last match, was superb. I think yesterday you could have put five or six of those games in your favourite 10-game album, I think.
That's the first blow to Ronnie Baxter.
And a break of throw.
I'm told that the final straw that broke the camel's back for Robert when he decided to join the PDC was he got to the last eight of the BDO Welsh Open and found that his prize money didn't match his train fare down from Scotland, and decided, this is crazy, I've got to give it a go.
Yeah, well, I think after winning the World Masters and then guaranteeing himself a place in the Grand Slam of Darts, I think it was only a matter of time before he switched across, and he's done extremely well. I mean, his rise up the rankings, it's absolutely been incredible in a short space of time. Like you said, if he wins this one, he's not far away from the 32. And this is why.
Oh, look at that. Lovely stuff from Thornton.
Yeah, I think you mentioned it yesterday. The actual standard 16 of games we had yesterday were spoilt, really. I mean, it was absolutely incredible.
It was one of the best days darts you'd ever wish to see, I think, yesterday. Superb. Let's hope that today can emulate it. And the early signs from this match are that they might.
I fancy this game could quite possibly develop to be the game of the day. I mean, although we had some big averages yesterday, Thornton's game was fabulous. It had everything.
One for the darts aficionado.
81.
No check out for Baxter. Thornton will get another three.
It's a great shot there from Ronnie. Just letting Robbie know that he's there.
Double top to strike back instantly for Robbie Thornton, and does so.
Two breaks a throw. And we're back where we started.
First to nine wins these quarterfinals. That was unlucky.
Absolutely. Bad deflection there. We've seen him yesterday. I think he started two or three legs with back-to-back 180s. 16.
He was doing plenty of that on the practice board, was he, this morning?
Yes, he was. We had a bit of fun yesterday. We had a practice yesterday as well, and we were seeing who could hit 10 180s first.
You win?
Yeah. 134.
And then this morning, I showed him how to hit the 141 as well.
93.
Good switch there by Ronnie. Good use of the 54. Robbie will be looking at a 140 at least here. Give himself a little bit of breathing space.
Ronnie had a 9-darter in Las Vegas as well, didn't he, in the qualifiers. Didn't actually get through.
No, he didn't. He actually didn't qualify on this occasion. Well, on that occasion. Just shows you how tough it is at the moment in them qualifiers.
140.
163, no checkout for Thornton.
Nope, you just set this one up. You come down to trouble 17 to leave 32, and there's the shot.
Lovely darts.
91. I had a feeling this was going to be a cracker.
92.
It's interesting how the crowd over here, the German crowd, okay, there's a fair few Brits who make it over as well, but the German crowd has noticeably got more knowledgeable as the week's got on, hasn't it? They've really started to get into it.
Yep, you can tell they're just sitting down appreciating good darts, and when it's exciting they get involved and they give the players the best of order and the chance to play the best darts, which I think is what we all want.
Thornton leading by 2-1 and producing that quality treble just when he needed it.
That's what Ronnie used to be so good at. Those 137s, I can remember playing him in the England Open many years ago, and he did exactly the same 12 dart legs, 3 on the trot. 140, 140, 137, and out. And he did that 3 times and beat me 3-0.
He's a very laid-back sort of character, isn't he? We were saying yesterday when he was playing, it's difficult to know just what emotions are going through him, isn't he? He's not one of the most demonstrative.
No, I think he's very much like Mark Walsh. You don't really know whether he's 10-0 up or 10-0 down. They don't give a lot away.
Mark Walsh, somebody who's been playing really well this week, and he's in action shortly.
Yes, big task on his hands later on against the one and only Phil Taylor.
52.
But he's looking forward to it.